We have Manila Mayor Isko Moreno. Good morning to you, Mayor Isko.
Hi, Karen. Good morning sa iyo. Happy New Year at Happy New Year sa iyong mga staff dyan sa ANC at ang inyong mga manonood.
Maraming salamat at sa inyo rin po, Happy New Year, Mayor Isko, at sa lahat po ng constituents sa Manila at maging po ng ating mga trabahador, public servants sa Manila City Hall. Let's start with this. Ano po ang plano ng Maynila to ensure that you will not have a rising number of COVID-19 cases with those returning to Manila, residents coming from the provinces, returning to Manila? And what are your latest numbers now?
Well, one, walang kasiguruhan na paano talaga mapigilan ng gusto yung paglago ng COVID-19. But be that as it may, as you can see, Manila is taking it conservative, in a conservative manner. With the recent EO and guidelines that we introduced to barangay officials to help us test those people who went on vacation. Kasi Karen, hindi naman kailan na rin sa atin na sa buong Pilipinas na ang COVID-19. No? Ang infeksyon ay nasa kanya-kanya na rin probinsya. So that's why so we can continue to suppress and control, hopefully, and make it plateau yung COVID infection sa Maynila, in-introduce natin ito pa rin libreng swab testing. One, for their peace of mind. Two, para na rin nilang pinangalagaan ng kanilang mga mahal sa buhay na naghihintay sa kanikanyang tahanan na sila ay na-test. That's why we encourage them to submit themselves to swab testing. Anyway, it's available, accessible, and it's free. No? At with regard to your next question, salamat sa Diyos, Karen, no? Talagang hindi kami mapagkatulog. Parang alumpihit kami for the past 30 days because taking the cue from scientists or specialists that there might be a surge or because of the holiday. Ang pinagpapasalamat ko sa Diyos ay hindi pa rin tayo lumago yung infeksyon sa loob ng 30 days. No? Nasa 295 tayo as of 12 p.m. yesterday, and it's been there with a 300 margin for the past 31 days ng buong December. But we will continue to manage it and control it in our own little way. But in this case, lalo na yung mga returnees, nakikisuyo kami. Anyway, it's for your own good. And certificates will be issued, yung health certificate, na magagamit din nila yon sa kanilang trabaho pagbalik na nila sa kanya-kanya trabaho.
Okay. Now, so this could be a model for many other cities in Metro Manila. How do you intend to implement it? You're requiring residents, of course, to be honest, right? Because you said Mayor, I was thinking there's so many entry points to the city of Manila. Hindi nyo naman po lahat nabantayan o nilista yung lumabas po at nagbakasyon. So how do you intend to implement this?
Well, we'll try to be better about the challenges ahead of us. No? Mm-mm. One thing for sure, wala namang nakabiyahe basta-basta sa kani-kanilang probinsya na hindi kumuha ng travel pass. So itong mga travel pass na ini-issue ng MPD at ng SHIELD, ng NCRPO, which I for one is also required. In fact, Karen, ako na mismo at sampu ng aking pamilya, talagang meron kaming travel pass. And because of these documents, we monitor those people who went to their respective provinces. And these are
at ilan
the first
po yun?
Person.
I'm curious, ilan po ang na-issuean yun ng travel pass for Christmas?
Well, a few thousand were issued. But having said that, it is not a perfect system. No? But as I have said, we will try to reach them as many as possible. That's why makikita mo, Karen, no, ang panawagan namin. While it is required, panawagan ko, mag-usa na lamang. Anyway, para na naman sa kaligtasan nyo ito. In fact, to share it to you, Karen, since we started this testing, we have tested about 121
Already.
Tapos, yeah. Under 121, may anim nang nakalabas. Kasi within 24 hours, Karen, lalabas ka agad yung resulta. And today, we have about 45 na lalabas sa ating quarantine facility. Kasi meron tayong quarantine facility na 14 na naitatag na natin na ginagamit natin ngayon as waiting area for the results of the COVID test.
No? Pero gano'ng katagal po?
At awa ng Diyos, wala pa nag-negative, wala pa nag-positive.
Actually, awa that's interesting Diyos. Kasi kunyari, no, may papabalik. Halimbawa po, nagpunta ng Baguio. Eh, ayaw po niya mag-quarantine facility. Gusto niya umuwi sa kanila. So, the requirement is, where do
barangay.
They go? Sa, magsaswab sa barangay.
Hindi, yung barangay, malalaman ng barangay, most likely.
Okay.
And kasi then, humingi rin sila ng permit sa barangay.
Okay.
So, I think, in the case of City of Manila, that's why it's very unique, we have 896 barangays. Alam mo naman, Karen, ang barangay namin, isang bloke lang, isang barangay na. And we have about 11 officials, no? And about 20 tanods. That 31 manpower. I think they know who and where those people went, no? At tingin ko madaling mamomonitor. Kaya in this approach na ginagawa ng pamahalang lungsod, malaking partisipasyon talaga ng barangay officials.
Oo. And kapag alimbawa po, isang buong pamilya sila, nagbakasyon, umuwi, magpapaswab, kailangan ba nandun pa sila sa quarantine facility or can they stay in their own homes considering it's the whole family anyway?
Anyway, huwag sila masyado mag-alala. Ang quarantine facility natin, we would suggest that they should be in a quarantine facility for their own good the community.
Yeah.
But ang quarantine facility natin, air condition, maliwalas naman, may wifi, may chicha pa. So we'll try to take care of you and make you comfortable for the next 24 hours.
At may aircon anyway, yung quarantine facility ninyo? Air-conditioned?
Air-conditioned po. Opo, okay. 14 po yan. We have about 600 plus. We always wanted to be ahead of the numbers of infection.
All right.
With regard to our load capacity with our quarantine facility and of course our COVID bed capacity, we went beyond the minimum requirements of DOH, which is 30%. We're about 32%. And these two quarantine, these two facilities are fully functional at unoccupied yung iba. So
okay.
We are in a good situation so far.
Very quickly, moving on to another topic, but will there be a penalty of some sort if the barangay chairman discovers that,
okay.
Let's say, hindi ka nagpa-swap, dumiretso ka lang sa bahay mo. May penalty ba ito, Mayor?
Karen, pag ikay positibo at iyo ipinabayaan, you might be violating some Republic Act. Mayroong batas para dyan. More than the IATF rule, no? Kaya mahalaga talaga, one, may peace of mind ka nang makukuha. Libre mong nakuha. Madali mong i-access. Two, at least kahit paano, alam mo kaagad paano i-address. And if you were going to turn out to be positive, we'll try to take care of you. And the key to success of the survival rate, with high survival rate, is early detection. Mas maaga namin
pero
kayong
may penalty
malaman.
Po ba? Wala namang
yes,
penalty. Anong penalty, sir?
May batas. Yung batas, they might be violating RA, Republic Act.
Pero hindi nyo naman po, ang tanong ko, what will you do in Manila? Will it be a fine? Hindi nyo naman
ano,
po papaaresto?
They might be facing criminal cases.
Criminal cases will
yes.
be filed.
Yes.
Okay. Now,
kaya ang preference ko lagi, instead of us being busy filing cases against person, we would encourage na sali na kayo, sama na kayo. The same thing with Karen, if I may take this opportunity. The same thing that we are now preparing to the pre-registration for COVID vaccination, yung ating nilos
yes.
noong...
I want to move to that. Okay.
Okay.
I want to move to that. Now, Manila plans to purchase its own set of vaccines from Pfizer. Is this correct? Is it only from Pfizer or are you looking at other producers? And where? How much do you want to buy? Where do you intend to get the money?
Okay. One, Karen, ang pera namin na itabi na namin mga 5 months ago pa, no?
How much?
200 million.
Okay.
Yan ay hindi lang batas, kundi nailagay na namin yan sa bangko. Mm-hmm. In preparation, hopefully, which is nangyari naman sa awa ng Diyos, na matagpuan ng maaga yung bakuna.
Mm-hmm.
Now, having said that, thanks to the Vice Mayor Hangi Lacuna, na itabi na namin yan, at yan ang nakipag-ugnayan agad kami sa mga malalaking pharmaceutical companies na kilala sa buong mundo. One of those is Pfizer and the other one is AstraZeneca. So we've been talking to them since July. Sa awa naman ng Diyos, nagbubunga naman yung aming talks. In fact, just for the record, the City of Manila signed already an NDA with the two companies mentioned. No?
Pfizer and Moderna. Pfizer to AstraZeneca. And AstraZeneca. Okay.
Yes. And the amount is about 200 million pesos. Now it became 250 million pesos. And if needed, no, we might go up to 1 billion pesos. Kasi meron kaming ginawa doon sa bagong budget sa 2021 na pwede namin dalhin doon kung sakaling kakailanganin. This is on top of the national government's effort to provide the City of Manila mm-hmm. as one of the beneficiary of 1,600
okay.
municipalities and cities in the country.
And so why didn't you negotiate with the Chinese vaccine, Sinopharm or Sinovac? Bakit po kumbaga Pfizer at AstraZeneca pinili po ninyo?
Hindi namin sila lang pinili, sila yung madaling kausap, madaling mm-hmm. hanapin, at mas open sila for discussion. So these are the things that we consider, those who are transparent, and siyempre we are very excited, Karen, no? I think all Filipinos who are watching right now, when we saw the news that Pfizer got their EUA in United Kingdom, then got their EUA in United States, and about a few days ago, more than a week ago, AstraZeneca got their EUA from British government.
Yeah.
So these are exciting times. So that's why sabi namin, kung sino yung mga nangunguna. So at that time, nung nakikipag-usap kami, nasa phase 2 na sila.
Yeah.
And ngayon, nasa phase 3, ngayon, may EUA na sila. And with the help of the president,
and in the Philippines, actually, Pfizer applied already, I think, for an EUA.
Yes, because of the EO of the president under 121, no? EO 121. So, taking the cue from the national government, kami rin, siyempre, I think even other mayors are also...
Do you have a verbal agreement already? I'm curious with Pfizer, just how many doses will they be able to give Manila? Kasi syempre, you have Secretary Galvez asking for the Philippines as a whole. And you have other cities, you have other ASEAN countries. How much can they give Manila?
Okay. I cannot discuss things, no? Naka-NDA na ako, no? Technical about the situation, whom company we are now. But as of now, sa conversation natin, dalawa lang naman yung pinag-uusapan pa natin. But the City of Manila wanted to acquire about 400,000 dosage. Under that 400,000 dosage or doses, yan ay makakabakuna ng 200,000 na mamamayan.
No?
And we're hoping with the help of Secretary Galvez and President Duterte, we might, after them issuing or giving EUA, we might enter into an agreement. Mm-hmm. We are hoping. But be that as it may, we are ready to help the national government in our own little way as a city government.
Yeah, but without breaking your non-disclosure agreement, I understand how limited you are with this.
Yes, I do.
The difference with the Pfizer vaccine is it requires negative 70 to 80% parang cold storage or that kind of storage. So if any city would buy it, I mean, I'm curious, will you build it? Will you make it? Or will they supply it?
Okay. Karen, I want to put it in right perspective, the way I look at it. One, it's a good problem. The logistical issues of whatever product is that, or the vaccine, no, available, is just one of, ano lang yung maliit na problema para sa akin, ha? While it is not available everywhere, but finding a cure or a vaccine that will keep safe the people is the biggest success in our history. So kung yun lang ang pagbabiyahe, logistics, tingin ko madali nang gawan ng paraan yun. In fact, even if I may mention, I saw it in the news, Pfizer created their own logistical packaging.
Yes, yes.
They call it the pizza box. A pizza box, they call it the pizza box. It's a container,
yes, yes,
wherein it can fit about 1,000 doses in one box and up to 5,000 doses that can travel within 5 days all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
And it can be deployed within 5 days also. But if you want to use it in the next 6 months, you have to store it for a certain degree, katulad nung nanabanggit mo kanina. But
mm-hmm.
more than anything else, what we want, Karen, sana dumating na yung bakuna, magkaroon sila ng EUA, then we, in the city of Manila, in our own little way, we are ready to deploy. Because 2 months ago,
I already asked
Manila Health Department
to prepare a them?
Plan.
And have you trained them?
Yes, yes. We plan already paano na i-deploy. Kasi ang maganda kasi sa mga kumpanyang mga nabanggit natin, no? Transparent sila sa mundo. So with their transparency, we take note of those journal or written journal.
Yeah.
And from there, we talk to our doctors, how are we going to approach this?
Okay.
And we've planned it already. So that's why we are now encouraging pre-registration.
Yes,
kasi
okay. Yes,
yeah.
go on. No, you're pre-registration.
Okay. That's why we are encouraging pre-registration because under the rule,
so I have
ang panawagan ng World Health Organization at saka DOH at IATF, sabi ni Presidente, uunahin ang medical frontliners. Susunod, senior citizen. So after that, halimbawa kami sa Maynila, no, we only have about 10,000 medical frontliners. Then we have about 130,000 senior citizen. If the first batch is about 200,000, cross finger, papagbigyan sana kami, so meron kami 60,000 na available. Alam mo, yung bakuna, kapag nasa bodega, walang bisa yan. So that's why we encourage them to log and register and launch this sa bagong taon, Manila COVID-19vaccine.com.
Okay. I wanted to ask you because I'm logged on. I'm logged on. I don't know if you can see me, but I'm logged on, although I'm not a resident of Manila. And it says here, so click to register and reserve, no? So isipin mo ngayon palang pwede ka na magpa-reserve. Pero
click
ano pong ibig sabihin
nito?
What does this mean?
Laman.
Manila CITREP pre... CITREP.
Manila CITREP.
What is that?
Situation report.
I see.
We wanted to be transparent as much as possible. Yung CITREP is the COVID situation, where it is, how it is, and sino yung mga gumagaling, mga namamatay, nakikiramay po ako, yung mga nai-infect and probable. Ayan naman yung pinipindot. Yan, Karen. And that is very important. Look at that, the other, ano, yan. With that, that's why we need to prepare, Karen, no? That questions will trigger us, the city government, and our medical frontliner to assess one person. Remember, a vaccine is voluntary. Mm-hmm. We need you to submit yourself and sign some documents and answer some queries. Let's just say, I'll put it in right perspective. Why is it very important? To know and to make it faster to deploy. No, para walang mahabang pila, mas epesyente. For example, pag nabakunahan ka, limbawa sa kagat ng aso, may prescribed time bago ka bakunahan ulit.
Oo.
May mga rules ang medical society o medical sector na kailangan naming sundin. Ayon na rin sa kanilang mga mabibisang karanasan at pag-aaral.
Oo. So, una, ang sino po ba ang qualified na magkaroon at mag-register, no, para sa libreng bakuna ng Maynila other? Of course, given na yon residents ng Manila. Pero ang tanong ko, meron po ba itong number one, income limitation? Kunwari, kapag ang taglay sa'yo o ang tingin sa'yo, may kaya ka, mayaman ka, pero Manila resident ka, you cannot avail of the free vaccine or dapat you belong to a certain income level at edad. May edad po ba na dapat yun ang mag-register? What are the qualifications?
Okay. One, it's been 10 months. We try to address everyone. Mahirap, middle class, mayaman.
Mm-hmm.
That's why free ang swabbing namin since March. and even our serology. We try to reach as many as possible. That's one. It's a matter of policy here in Manila. The same thing when you give ayuda. Mahirap, middle class, mayaman. Pantay-pantay. Why are we going to do the same thing with vaccination? It's a universal problem. Mm-hmm. It doesn't distinguish when you're rich or you're poor, magkakasakit ka or not. So the fastest that we can survive, the fastest that we can recover is the effort that is commendable. Yun ang dapat na gawin. So that's why we will make this vaccine free for everyone. As many as possible. Kaya makikita mo, Karen, halimbawa, no, nakita mo yung numbers na binigay ko sa iyo kanina, at 200 million, it became 250, and may fallback pa kami na 1 billion. So the logic behind it, if it is effective, if it is sufficient and efficient, then I want the city of Manila to be safe as much as possible. Then the another challenge is about 600,000-700,000 people will come in and out of Manila in a regular given day. And I wanted to take them, give them access to free vaccine also. Why
you
not?
Mean even
that's the purpose of the national government.
Kahit hindi po resident, dumaan sa Manila.
Yes. Yes, why not? It's a universal problem.
Yes.
But then it has to be approached inclusively.
But do you have all the means? Kumbaga, the intention is good, but do you have all the means?
And I'll tell you why and how. Okay. Kaya ko kinansel ang mga paggawaing kalsada, Karin. Sa totoo lamang, in 2021 budget, in 2020 budget, it was done 2019. Nobody saw or envision that there will be pandemic. Okay. But hindi na pwedeng ikubli ng mga mayor, kaming mga mayor, na hindi kami maghanda sa 2021 with regard to our annual budget. So that's why what we wanted and what we did with the help of the city council and the vice mayor, no, nag-appropriate kami ng isang pondo to address FSP or yung aming mitigation program for socioeconomic impact sa COVID-19, which is food security program. With that funds, we'll try to assess kung ano ang sitwasyon sa trabaho at hanap buhay ng tao. No? But having said that, we can redirect that so that magamit naman namin for COVID-19 vaccine. Kasi it may arrive on the first quarter, it may arrive on the second quarter. So meron tayong minimum working plan for the next 6 months of Manila. So, yun yung point natin. Ginawa natin, pasensya na kayo mga kababayan, ha? Baka makakita kayo ng mga lubak-lubak na kalsada sa lungsod ng Maynila. Isinantabi ko po lahat yan.
I see.
Opo, isinantabi ko talaga. With all honesty, you can see it in our budget. Nilagay ko lahat yan sa food security program and vaccination program. To really, you know, help everyone as much as possible.